Hello guys, KP Shamino here with a new video for Fishing Planet. And yesterday was the anniversary qualifier cup at round one. And yeah, it was not so good for me. It was not good because I had very small fish, but I had 15 trophy salmon. So it was really good fishing, but they were not big enough. So to give you guys an example, so you guys can see, this was my biggest fish, and my biggest fish was almost as big as the average what the first guy got. So he got like 10 average fish of 8.6 kilogram. So yeah, I was really unlucky. You cannot do a lot about it. It's now two tournaments that the RNG is really bad. And in the competitions, my RNG is really low too. So always I got the fish in the lower range that they start. So I had yesterday, I think, 6 or 7 salmons under 7 kilograms. So yeah, you cannot do a lot about it. It's how it is. You need to sit it out. At some time the RNG pops up and you're going to get like very big fish, and then you go further to the semis. But I saw something that I want to share with you guys, because I fished with the deep runner, not the deep runner, but the triple runner, in a combination with the crankbait 401. I think that the most people fish that way, so I will show you guys it. So I used this a lot, and what I saw in practice was, I practiced 2-3 times on a sunny day and on a cloudy day, that it's a very good lure to fish for salmon. You're going to catch a lot of normal ones. You're going to get the trophy 1-2. It's going to produce more fish. I cannot say it's going to give more trophies. I cannot say that. But if you want to fish outside the competition and you don't have access to the crankbait, because it's an X series, so the crankbait that the most people used is this one. But of course, you need to have access to it. In the past, I had a lot of them. I got now 2, and I think I got 3 in my home the boat too. But I use this one a lot too, and I'm going to show you guys some fishing and the spots that I use in the competition. So the triple runner 4 meter 3.0, I think that you can unlock it on level 33, so that's perfect for Alberta. And yeah, it's not gold bait coins, or it's not X series. So let's get started, guys. So I'm not sure what kind of day we got the next day. So we got now a snowy day, and I'm going to fish, I think, here at around 6 a.m. And just to show you guys how it works, because it's very simple to fish with. Yeah, let's get started. Okay, so my setup first. The setup is the RiverTech Zoys 250 Thunderspin 5500, Fluoro 0.55, and then the triple runner 4 meter 3.0. So yeah, where do you need to go? Yeah, there is only one peg that you can go, and then you need to come over here. Yeah, and it's not on Azerti again, therefore I just yeah, changed my lure. So let's have a look that I can find it back with the best system that they ever implemented in the game. Here we go. We are already in this day. I'm going to switch to this day then, because I like to fish more in this day, because I didn't test this day. So we are going to a cloudy day. Here we go, around 11 o'clock. I know 11 o'clock it starts to pick up, so. Okay. So you guys see a lot of markers. So what did I do? I just throw around the lake, and if I got trophy, I just put the marker out. So you guys can see it where I got the salmons. I think those two markers are for the lake trout. That's another competition, but I think this is trophy. Yes, this is trophy. You can see it. The triple runner 4 meter. Here I used the crankbait 3.5 meter 4.0. This is the crankbait 2. Was that a trophy? No, a normal one. This is a normal one too. And then on the other side we got the trophy. So we got 4 spots that I use. And we are going to throw on them. So what you need to do is very easy fishing. It's a little bit boring because yesterday after 1 hour just clicking, because you just need to retrieve. That's all what you need to do. You cannot do more with the runners, so you cannot do a stop and go. You can just do a straight retrieve. It's a little bit the same, and there is already a fish. And that's what I mean. The triple runners, they work really, really well for the Atlantic salmon. So I saw it right away. I started to use this one, and I had right away. It was bite, bite, bite after bite. I was like, whoa, this is going to be very good for the competition. I went to the competition. It's good still in the competition, but it was not as good as it is now. Therefore, I think this works really well on a cloudy day. On a sunny day, it works really well too, but the Crankbait X series is the same level than this one on a sunny day. The Crankbait X series 4.0 is not the same level on a cloudy day than this one. This is a lot better. You guys saw it right away a very strong strike, and yeah, you can reel all the way to the to the shore here. So let's have a look that I got another fish. How do I fish in the tournament? I just get two fish, then I go to the next spot. So you alternate the whole time because I got the impression that this lake does not work like the other lakes. In other lakes, you got a trophy or you got a fish, then you need to wait out 30 minutes. No, sometimes it can be so dead that it seems there is no fish anymore. Then it picks up, you get like 10, 15 fish sometimes, trophy after trophy, back-to-back trophy at the same position. So there is not really a pattern, I think, in this lake. And that's not bad, but that means that the RNG is very, very important if you go to the tournament or if you go to the big red fish. Because in the big red fish, you need to fish with the crankbait. You cannot fish with the triple runner because I don't think they are crankbaits. But it's just the same system with the spots. But there you need to go with the X series most of the time. So now I went to the second spot because I did my two rotation on the first spot. So let's have a look that there is a fish on this spot. It can take some time sometimes. Sometimes you need to sit it out. Sometimes it's very active right away. I'm going to throw now 2 times on that marker. Then I'm going to get to the third marker 2 times. And I'll go all the way, guys, because I got so many trophy salmons just in front of me. Like you just lift them out of the water, so it's worth to just keep reeling. In the past, I did something. Yeah, in the past, it's like 2, 3 years ago. Sometimes it works too if you just stop for a brief moment. I got a couple of times that I just did this, and then I started again. Can you do something about the bites? So sometimes you're going to get a bite. You will see it. You get a bite, but the fish is spitting it out. What I saw was there is not a technique that you can overcome that problem. Most of the time, that means that it's small fish or that your hook is too big. But the 3.0 and a 4.0 will work for the Atlantic salmon. So you will get with this setup, you will get brook trout, you will get the splake trout because it's a 3.0 instead of a 4.0. So it's not only the Atlantic salmon. You are rarely going to get a lake trout, and that's very good if you want to target the salmon, of course. And it's not so good at the moment. So the first spot, and you guys see right, you see the action everywhere. So you see jumping fish, and that's the salmon that is jumping around. So we are going to try spot number 3 because I already did a couple of tries. So this spot is not active at the moment. So let's go to spot number 3 and let's have a look that there is a fish waiting for us. The best time on a sunny day we fished in the tournament between noon and 8 p.m. And I saw that the best time was starting around 5 p.m. It was very good between 5 and 6 p.m. and then it went down until 8 p.m. So But as you can see, a sunny day is not coming that much in Alberta. So you guys can see it here. Because in the practice I need to use like around 15 bait coins to forward the days to a sunny day. So yeah, it's not coming that much, but you can catch a nice amount of salmon in the other weather types too. Yeah, and there is another one, so that's number two. So what we are going to do now is I wanted to go to the right spot, but I'm going to do one more throw here, because I always want to get the second one. If it is not coming, we go to the last spot, and then I'm going to end the video, guys. Then you know what you need to do. I fished with the runners on a couple of other fish too, like the walleye. It seems to work decent. If you go here with the 6 meters one, so the deeper one, you're going to get lake trout. But I just tested for 5 minutes. I fished with the deep runners on the pike in Germany too. That works really well too. So there is a lot of fish that you can catch with these runners. But of course, we need to test it. And yeah, it's not always easy to test it. So I'm going to do one more throw because it was back-to-back salmon, so we already got 3 of them. Let's have a look that we can get the third one. Yes, the spot is active. That is what I mean, guys. So you do two, three throws, and you're not getting a fish. And then suddenly, bang, bang, bang. It's like, yeah, you will almost think that they are swimming around like in the new lake system. It's a possibility that is happening here too. Yeah, that's now 3 times. So let's try to get a fourth one. So you guys can see the runner delivers. I think it's not very good for only getting trophies. Why? Because it got a smaller hook. It's a 3-0 hook, so I think you're going to get more normal Atlantic salmons. You can get the trophies with it. I'm not saying that. But this is a lot better to make money, in my opinion. Because you can see it, I'm catching a shitload of Atlantic salmons. And I'm not sure that this is one. That's 4 times an Atlantic salmon back to back. So let's try the 5th time. Here we go. It's a very good spot. I got the impression that the first spot is very good for the 4 meter one. The right spot is very good for the 4 meter one. And the middle spot here, the second one, is better for the crankbait. I'm not sure, it's just maybe placebo effect in my head. But I saw it in the competition too, in the tournament. So, because what did I do? I did a rotation 2 times, 2 times, 2 times, 2 times. And then I went 2 times, 2 times, 2 times, 2 times with the crankbait. And it seems to work really well, because I had 15 trophies in total, and that's a lot. Because a trophy is not something that you're going to catch like every cast. And now I think the spot is dry. And now we are going to the last spot over here. So you guys can see it on the markers. I don't move, because yeah, moving is losing time, of course. Let's have a look that there is a salmon lurking on this position too. And then I'm going to end the video, guys. So you can have a lot of fun. If you come here, I'm not really know when Alberta is opening. I think somewhere at the end of 28 or the 20th and start on the 30th level. I'm not sure, but it's very good for this lake if you want to get a lot of those fish. This is a good one. Is this? Oh no, it's a lake trout. I was already thinking it. So let's do another throw. And let's have a look that we can get a salmon to end the video. And then we start over again. There is another fish. So yeah, very good. Very good minnow. This is called the minnows, the runners. But it's a very good lure that you can use in this area. So that's number 7 or 8 already, I think. 32 kilograms, 42 minutes in game. So if you can do a combination now with like 2 bottom rods and you go for the lake trout with spawn sack in the hole here at the left, I think you can make a very decent money with if you do it like this. Are we going to get one more fish, or is it now dried up the spots? And yeah, I need to start the rotation again on spot number one. So you can go all the way here to the shore because you can catch him in front of you. So that was it for the video, guys. I wanted to share with you guys a little bit the knowledge. So yeah, I cannot say more, guys. So if we check now the net, you will see that I got 7 fish, I got 6 Atlantic salmons, and I got 1 lake trout in 40 minutes in-game fishing. So thanks for watching, have fun, and I hope to see you guys in next video. Bye bye.